It's a seat that's been in the spotlight plenty of times now, the U.S. Senate seat that the governor appointed Kirsten Gillibrand to fill last January, you know, after Hillary Clinton became Secretary of State. Well, tonight, the three Republicans who hope to unseat her debated at Union College in Schenectady, 3 weeks ahead of the primary.
Kirsten Gillibrand is one of the worst offenders of spending money we don't have.
They each took a turn taking a shot at Senator Kirsten Gillibrand. So when pressed to say something nice about the Democratic opponent,
attractive woman, I think she's bright, and I think she's probably a good mom herself.
She really positioned herself well in terms of being the one appointed to the Senate.
I will say I've admired her interest in the nutrition issues.
But the niceties didn't last long for this trio, especially when it came to each other.
You were the presiding officer in Nassau County at a time, in 1 year at least, they raised taxes 9%.
You were one of the most liberal Republicans in the House of Representatives.
Joe DiAguardi, Bruce Blakeman, and David Malpass bickered through the second half of the hour-long debate.
When you were the chief economist for Bear Stearns, your firm, Bear Stearns, took bailout money.
You oversaw the biggest tax increase in Nassau County history. Look
That's
at the
lie.
New York Times.
That is a lie.
New York.
It makes sense to go after the former Nassau County legislator. Blakeman secured more than 50% of the vote at the Republican convention. But CPA and former Congressman Joe DiAguardi has a slight lead in the polls and the conservative party line. And when asked whether the Tea Party is helping or hurting the GOP, each candidate was careful not to offend potential supporters.
I think the Tea Party movement is one of the most refreshing things to happen to America in a long, long time.
The Tea Party is a constructive thing in New York. We need an upheaval. We need huge change.
I think it's a blessing that we've got so many people now interested in speaking up.
YNN hosted the debate tonight, and in the so-called lightning round, where the candidates can only answer yes or no, we learned all three men support the death penalty. None of them have ever milked a cow, and they all believe Rick Lazio should debate Carl Paladino. Paladino is running against Lazio in the Republican primary for governor. He's been calling on Lazio to debate next week, but Lazio has declined, saying he just can't fit it in his schedule. Well, after the debate, Senator Gillibrand's office responded, sending a statement to our newsroom. It says in part, quote, none of the Republicans passed the credibility test. None are capable of serious solutions that will create good-paying jobs and get our economy growing again.